Hello and welcome to the Red Hat Advanced Cluster Security for Kubernetes product update, also known as What's New in 4.7. 4.7 is a packed release filled with new features such as software bill of materials generation or SBOM generation, updates to vulnerability management workflows and secure credential management in ACS, and of course, integrations with Red Hat Developer Hub and GitHub Container Registry. Make sure to check the description as there will be links and timestamps in the description below, and certain sections will have a follow-along link that you can click on to get an overview of the new feature. In 2025, the ACS team is targeting three major releases, the first being this one, 4.7 in March. Full support begins at the GA or release of a minor version and lasts for 6 months. During that time, security advisories and high-priority bug fixes are released as needed. Customers and users are expected to upgrade to the latest supported version for updates. After that 6 months of full support, you get an additional 4 months of maintenance support. During this phase, critical security issues will be addressed and some high-priority bugs may also be fixed. After that 10 months, software and documentation will always remain available, but support ends. The first feature I want to cover is the software bill of materials or SBOM generation in ACS. Now, SBOMs list all the components and libraries in a software product, helping organizations understand what software they're using and running in their Kubernetes clusters. This largely stemmed from the NIST executive order back in 2021, and in ACS 4.7, we're bringing SBOM generation through the UI and the command line, and that's with the RHACS CLI, so you can shift it left in your pipeline. Now, this is the analyze-specific type of SBOM generation, and I'll leave a link in the description below if you'd like to learn more about the different types or if you want to walk through a demo of the feature yourself. ACS 4.7 brings a significant change in the vulnerability management and violations dashboard. 4.7 aims to help bridge the gap between user-facing software and platform-specific software. This includes vulnerability breakdowns, such as user workloads and platform nodes, as well as more views that include vulnerable images, inactive images, images without a vulnerability, and Kubernetes components. If you go over to the violations dashboard, you'll see a similar workflow with workload violations, platform violations, and all violations. Check out the link in the description below if you want to walk through it yourself. ACS 4.7 is introducing the exploit prediction scoring system, EPSS scores, to the vulnerability management dashboard. These scores range from 0 to 100%, and they predict the likelihood of a vulnerability being exploited within the next month. The higher the score, the greater the indication that an exploit will take place. Now, EPSS scores are another tool as a part of a greater vulnerability management remediation workflow. ACS 4.7 introduces auto-rotation to automatically renew certificates used for MTLS communication within secured clusters. Previous releases used init bundles for both bootstrap credentials and MTLS certificates, posing security risks as they couldn't be revoked if compromised. With ACS 4.7, separate credentials are used for both bootstrapping and communications, allowing revocation of the bootstrap credentials and a clear separation of trust. ACS 4.7 enhances integration with Azure Registry and Microsoft Sentinel, using short-lived OpenID Connect or OIDC credentials from Microsoft's identity provider. These credentials authenticate ACS services to Azure APIs. This is building on the 4.4 release integration with other cloud providers like AWS and GCP. This update also introduces machine-to-machine authentication through Azure AD service principles, allowing more secure API access. Additionally, OIDC identity tokens from Microsoft's Enter ID can now be exchanged for ACS access tokens to automate tasks such as image scans and checks. ACS 4.7 ships with an integration into Red Hat Developer Hub. This brings vulnerability information directly into the developer's dashboard, and it will be consistent between the developer and the security personnel. Now, for those new to Red Hat Developer Hub, it's a build of the open source Backstage project designed to create customizable internal developer portals that boost productivity specifically for developers. This integration will help to catch early issues and improve the communication between developers and security teams, as they'll be able to see the exact same vulnerability information across Developer Hub and ACS. ACS 4.7 now includes an out-of-the-box integration with GitHub Container Registry, making it easier for organizations to scan container images hosted in GHCR. This integration supports both public and private instances, allowing ACS to access container images and produce vulnerability scan results more efficiently. The ACS team really wants to thank you for watching, and this is a reminder to get the release notes, a walkthrough of specific features, and more all in the description below, and we'll see you back here for ACS 4.8.